this is the 13th season of Watermelon Wednesdays. And I was going to have 13 shows for 13 years, but I couldn't resist, so I have a 14th show. And you can get the list of the complete series on the website, watermelonwednesdays.com, or just grab one on your way out or during intermission. There will be an intermission. We will serve watermelon as usual, and the bats, what are left of them, will come out of the belfry at that time. And I'm not going to read to you who's going to play here this summer, because it would take most of the first set. And I think you'd rather hear Louise and Ray. I won't bother, except to say it's amazing. It's so great to have a series on Wednesday when all these great people are between New York and Boston and want to make a little money and come to a nice place and, you know, play in front of a group like you who really love the music and are not drinking and smoking and carrying on and ignoring the musicians. So this is great. Right? Right. So anyway, I think that's it. I would like to thank, I should thank my sponsors. I have sponsors this year for the first time who will allow me to make enough money to buy an extra microphone, maybe. And not Swiss sponsors. It's unbelievable. Okay, so I'd like to thank the Massachusetts Whately Cultural Council for their generous donation, which will allow me to buy enough watermelons for two concerts. I would like to thank Signature Sounds also, Jim Olson and Signature Sounds. I would like to thank the First Congregational Church of Whately, who actually owned this building and let it be used for this purpose. And I would like to thank Lawrence Savings Bank, my first real mainline business sponsor. And I would like to thank you all for patronizing these great artists and come all the way out here to the center of the universe to hear the best music that I can find anywhere on the planet. And so I'm very happy to bring two of the best blues players on the planet here tonight. So you're getting two for one. And Louise Tayler and Ray Bonneville are just terrific people. And you will find out how terrific they are as soon as I get up on stage, which is going to be right now. So enjoy the show. There'll be an intermission and watermelon.
I've been living in Hawaii for the last 5 years. So I'm cold. Thank you. okay? Is it too loud?
No.
It's all right. Okay, praise the Lord. See this cord here? This was an ensuing argument here. We got here, we're missing a cord. And this is our short cord. I drew the short cord. So this next song is off of my newest CD. I accidentally made a CD. Recently, I had moved to Hawaii and kind of just stopped playing music. And I was playing, but I wasn't playing out. I wasn't touring or anything. And I wasn't going to make a CD. And then I flew to my old producer's house, Peter Galway and Annie Gallup, good friends of mine. They said, "Oh, just come and see. Maybe we'll get a song, you know, we'll record a song." Next thing I know, I had an album. And I'm real proud of this album, and I like it a lot. I like it, you know. And for a lot of my career, I would go, "Well, it's okay," you know, the ones that I did. But this one I really love. This is called "Walk 5 Miles." I wrote it about Katrina, what happened with Katrina, and then of course everybody on the East Coast got hit last year, right? How was it down here? Was it too bad, or was it okay? Pretty bad, right? Yeah, Vermont. I was watching from Hawaii. I was watching YouTubes of my little covered bridges blasting away. It was pretty intense. It was really hard to be away from Vermont. I'm sorry I was gone, you guys. I would have pitched in.
You still can't?
Oh, just kidding.
Nature's way, simple as a rain, coming down.
Well, I went back to my hometown of Brattleboro. After I moved to Arkansas for a while. That was intense. Ray actually bought a house down there. And he was convinced it was going to be the next artist community. And then a couple years later, I bought a house because I couldn't really afford one in Vermont. I got it for $35,000. Cute little place on an acre lane. But the problem is I had to live there. It's not so cool. I liked it, sorta. You know, it sorta looked like Vermont. I went back to Brattleboro and I was actually staying at my friend Molly's house. And I wrote this song. This is, I had spent the evening walking around Brattleboro late, sort of wondering where I was going to stay that night, and realized that the town didn't really remember me. I was born there, but it didn't really remember me.
So gone. Pair of baby hands.
blues and a baby blues. See the little birds flitting around my head, singing good morning, girly, how do you do? All over what I hear. Oh, a new set of baby blues. If I could dream with you, you know I'd be satisfied. Just flying along, holding on to the string of something so wild. If I was a child with itty bitty baby hands, I'd only hold on to what I could comprehend. Oh, what I'd give for a new pair of baby hands. Oh, what I'd give for a new pair of itty bitty.
Ray and I were haven't really hung out together much in the last many years, and so we hopped in the car together. Exactly. It's always trying experience. We made it up to Ripton, Vermont the other night. We were careening down a dirt road at, I thought, probably 100 miles an hour.
30.
Felt like 100. And the road was like washed out over there. He couldn't see. I could see. The road was washed out. And there were lots of branches down and leaves down and all sorts of things. Right, Ray?
No.
Somehow we wound up in the National Forest up there. You know, we were supposed to, we were following our GPS, and instead of going from one road to the next, it took us around through the National Forest. What's the name of that forest? You're Gonna Die Forest, I think it's called. You're Gonna Die Now. Thank you. give all that, the things that you believe, empty your pocket, the trinkets that you
doing?
Great. How could that be? It's a brand new amp. traveling across the country a couple years ago, a wonderful woman named Natalia Zuckerman. Does anyone know her music? She's great. She's a singer-songwriter. And I met her at a wedding of a mutual friend and that had been always saying we should get to know each other. And I talked with her for, you know, half hour, and we liked each other. We, you know, saw the wedding together and everything. And then a couple months later, she called me up and asked me if I wanted to go on tour with her, that she would book the tour, and all I had to do was show up with my guitar, and she would drive. And I was like, okay, I guess I'll go. So this song came directly from that. It's just my vision of our road trip, and also my vision of what love, this kind of elusive thing, love is. And one of the ideas from this song were from when I was out in a diner in the Midwest, getting a sandwich, you know, and I was looking down at my menu and trying to figure out what to order, and I look over, and there's this gorgeous waitress who's with her back to me, and she's got long blonde hair and long beautiful legs, and I'm thinking, wow, what's she doing waitressing? And then I go back to my menu, and I'm about to, you know, order. She comes over the table, and I'm saying, looking at the menu, I say, I'll have number 7, grilled cheese. Look up, and her face is nothing like the rest of her. It's sort of brought to mind, like, she looks good from behind. Or it's good in the dark.
Reverend John.
And thank you, David. David Fuller. Ray, do you want to come up and do something? I'm not really a blues player, but I'm trying to keep it bluesy. We're introduced as blues players.
You're a bluesy girl, though, I'll tell you that.
Bluesy. Blues-like. So wonderful to be back here and play for my people. Because you really are. It's so fun to come out and see people that look like me. Oh, yeah. I do fit in. Hawaii is really nice, though. Not complaining.
They look like you there?
No, they don't look like me there. Not really. Everyone wears flowery shirts.
Walks into a bar.
Thank you.
He says to the bartender, "I'm looking for my brother." The bartender says, "What does he look like?"
Cherry tree, cherry tree, looky here.
How you guys doing? All right. It's really, really nice to come here. I feel good here. Don't know why, but I do. My friends are here. That's why. Play some songs here. Louise and I have been touring for about a week now, and we played down in New York and in Ripton, Vermont, where my GPS had a relationship with Vermont, and it was confused in the relationship.
Told her more than once. I'll put your six under if you try to run. She walked into the pawn, said I'll take that little 32.
What you done?
to the coming storm, they regularly fly. A dozen more against a darkening sky. A million jokers with laughing eyes. I'll kill Crow John for who knows why.
School, but they put me in with some kids who weren't interested in school, you know, and so I kind of floundered, but I got a guitar out of it, so I was real happy about that, you know. So I went back to Montreal in 1990, and, you know, Montreal, they speak French, they speak English, and they speak French and English at the same time sometimes.
chasing swan. Can you hear me, darling? I've been calling, calling. Baby, I'm all alone. I tap up to my location.
Sing you a song about a bank robber, maybe? Yeah. Okay, I'll do that. It's called Bad Man's Blood, and it's a song about influence, I guess you might say. So nice to see all of you here. We weren't sure if we'd have like 6 people. Papa said goodbye through the glass on the prison phone. Mama never cried, just said, boy, you a bad man, son. Under a no moon sky, headlights cut the night on this dark road to nowhere. It's just a matter of time before I have to pay the price for what I've done back there.
Got a bad man. I would pray for a friend to help me through this long, long night. They're coming to take me away in the morning, come daybreak.
Come see my brother around here back in the 70s. Went to UMass, and he had my wife and a house around here and a couple of dogs. And I used to come out here and say hi to him. That's close by, right? It's called Tomorrow's Yesterday.
Thank you.
question with no reply. A lot of dawn's coming on over the horizon. Tomorrow's yesterday, hey. My lover, say you come my way, my way.
July 7th.
Hey, Dave, you got your harmonicas?
What?
Let's play a little song together, man.
Okay.
Are you up for it?
Oh, sure.
Dave, come on, ladies and gentlemen. In Arkansas one time, like a fool. I was sitting in that house and I looked on the wall late one night and I saw a spider walking. Big cup of water. I looked at that spider, he was walking, not making a sound. I got to thinking about that spider, you know. What it'd be like to be that spider. You might have seen my web somewhere along the way. Hiding close by there in the shady shade. I was built for silence. You never will hear me. I could be right beside you and you'd never know a thing. I'm a tiptoe spider. Yeah, I'm a tiptoe spider and I don't make no sound.
you do when you come my way. You put a soup on my worry. You put a soup on my worry. Like a cool rain on a hot day.
City so much for so much influence, and I'm sure lots of people are the same way, you know. And I went down there a couple, I don't know, maybe 5-6 months ago. I've been down there before that too, and I drive around through the lower Ninth Ward where the water was up to the roofs, you know, and still it's a car and a house with some paint on it and the lights are on, and then you got to go a whole block before you see another one. All our houses are empty still. But
But those houses that have paint on them and the lights on, they're like little green shoots coming through the ashes after a forest fire. It seemed like, you know, forest is going to come back, but it's going to take a while. Anyway, after the storm, I was thinking about, you know, how the city has been left on its own to fend for itself. And so I thought I'd write something where the city could speak to the world, you know. It was called I'm the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Next day we get to go, come on, I was just kidding.
Yeah.
On the day before she's going, you are being ridiculous. it's not ridiculous, it's the D, right? Ridiculous.
Thank you so much.
I thought it was going to be cold in here.
I don't think it was.
And at the end of my set, I'm warm. I wrote a song here that's from my friend who I lost, childhood friend. His name was John, and we used to do a lot of foolish things together. And I miss him, you know. When he died, I wrote this song for his family and his wife and for me, so I could think about him. Called River John. Thanks so much for coming. Louise has three or four of her albums, and I have three, my three latest ones. A new one's called Bad Man's Blood, and the one before that's called Gone by Feel, and the other one is called Roll It Down, and I would like for you to each buy two dozen. But no, I've really been having a ball here tonight at the Watermelon. I've heard about this place, and I went, you know, the Watermelon there. Watermelon, I don't know.
Wednesdays.
And now I've experienced it, and I hope I can come back. Hope Louise can come back. You want to come back here?
Yes.
And I want to thank our sound people, Louise Tayler and Ray Bonneville. How about a hand for David Fuller, ladies and gentlemen? Yeah. How about you? Sang this one together. Did I sing this one with you on your record or not?
No. I recorded your song, and you told me after I recorded it that I sang the melody and the harmony, not the melody.
Yeah, but yeah. You have a right to do that.
Yeah. It was like you didn't sing any of the melody. That's what you said.
Did I?
Yeah.
That's rude. No wonder you get mad at me. I'm just a rude guy. I think I was drinking, right?
No. Maybe you were, I don't know.
You should be.
I'm going to start now, I'll tell you that. I mean, you guys are really, really great. Really great.
Yeah,
thanks
really
for coming.
Really fun. Thank you so much.
Hey, don't know, love is love.
I got something rolling around my head. I will tell you.